I said, then what happened, brother? He said, Steve, nigga, it looks so goddamn good, I ate myself. And you know, and I know that everybody gotta eat. If you're a human being, you gotta eat sometime. Everybody gotta eat sometime. Animals gotta eat sometime. Everybody gotta eat sometime. That's why sometime, you stop and think, what do animals eat? You know what cows eat? They like grass. You know that birds like peanuts and things of that nature. Somebody looked at me and I thought about something that we don't realize. Alligators have to eat. What do alligators eat? You think that they don't like fish? They don't like grass? They don't like animals? Two alligators down there in Florida. Later, one was real fat, 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 as healthy as he could be. Another one was a little thin, frail alligator. And the fat one looked at the thin one and said, what's wrong with you? You ain't eating nothing. Little skinny alligator said, I eat every damn day. Fat alligator said, well, what you eat? Thin one said, I eat meat. I'm all big, black, greasy motherfucking niggas. That's what I eat, them goddamn niggas. Fat one said, well, what you mean? Tell me about it. He said, well, I just get up on there and grab me one of them motherfuckers and drown him in the water, take my tail and beat the shit out the motherfuckers. Then I eat his black ass. Fat alligator said, that's why you lose so much goddamn weight. He said, what do you mean, goddamn? I grab the motherfuckers, take my tail and beat the shit out of them, and then I eat that black ass. Fat one said, that's your goddamn problem. Anytime you beat the shit out of a nigga, you ain't got nothing left. Lord knows I tell it like it is. And when I used the word shit, I saw some debonair young lady look at me and said, he said, shit. Yeah, I say shit. Shit, goddammit. Every son of a bitch in here, you crackers, you niggas, all of you shit sometime. Show me one son of a bitch in here that don't take a shit, and I'll show you somebody's full of shit. And don't look at me and say, why don't Steve have class and say, do-do? When you get my motherfucking age, nigga, you don't do-do, you shit. And shitting is a way of knowing yourself. Knowing yourself. See, you can really know yourself if you know how you shit. See, people that have love in their heart, when they sit down, they shit. Reach for the toilet paper, wipe their shitty ass, and flush it down. People that have larceny shit in the same way. Reach for the toilet paper, wipe their shitty ass, but before they flush it down, because they have larceny, they have to turn around and peep at that shit. Any son of a bitch don't trust his own asshole got to have larceny. What you think gonna come out your asshole but some shit? Now just suppose you shit a rainbow tail. What you gonna do with the motherfucker? Bring it down here to the Excelsior Club and say, Jimmy, mount my shit on the wall. Lord knows I tell it like it is. And when you tell the truth, everything becomes so magic and wonderful. That's why I love talking to people that understand the truth. My old lady, my wife, don't understand that shit, though. Bitch got mad at me because last year I didn't give her no birthday present. I fixed the ass this year. I said, babe, I got you a present. She said, what is it? I said, there's your present in the box on the sofa. She said, what is it? I said, it's your fucking present. Why don't you get up off your lazy fat ass and open up the box and see what it is? She opened up the box and there was a present, a live skunk. She said, what the fuck am I gonna do with a live skunk? I said, grow your fur coat, goddammit. I bring you ice cream, you want candy. I bring you candy, you want cookies.
I bring you cookies, you want a fucking watermelon. Here's your present, a skunk. She said, but where am I going to keep a live skunk? I said, keep him in the bedroom with us. She said, but what about that smell? I said, let him get used to it like I did. You have to get used to these things. That's why a lot of women sitting up here right now laughing their ass off. Never had a man eat the pussy. You know, it's weird, though. Girls hear me talking about that shit. Girls hear me talking about that shit. And they sit and they look and they wonder. Like, there's two women here that you hear me talking so much about eating pussy, and two women here never had a man do that to them. And you gotta wonder why nobody don't head in that direction with you. Motherfucker don't head in that direction. Well, bitch, you don't have to wonder no goddamn more, because I'm gonna tell you why. You wanna know why? Goddamn it, I'll tell you why. It's because you're funky. Nigga got some respect for his lips, goddamn. Nigga might eat pussy, but ain't gonna eat no funk factory. And some woman sitting up here laughing her ass off right now don't even know her husband, one of the best cocksuckers in the club. But the niggas in Charlotte that eat pussy are the lightest motherfuckers in the world. And especially these married cocksuckers. They'll eat any strange bitch they meet and look you straight in the eye and say, I wouldn't do that to my wife. Now, why can't she get some of the good stuff, goddammit? Some nigga sitting over here right now, I've been looking at that motherfucker all night long. Eat any motherfucking bitch, but he won't eat mama. Here comes some more cocksuckers.
Speak soft, man.
Yeah, them white cocksuckers. Don't look at them like they don't do that shit. They the ones started the shit. Niggas picked it up. Them white motherfuckers been doing that shit a long time. And they used to tell us it's nasty. But don't feel bad about it. Eating pussy has helped integration. You notice how we drink and wine and dine together now? Years ago, niggas wouldn't eat pussy. Niggas couldn't even drink at the water fountain. Now the niggas eat pussy, crack will tell you in a minute. Go and drink, boy. Drink all the water you want, boy. And the weirdest thing about it, people that eat pussy is weird. Niggas and crackers, all of them lie to each other. Example, like you can catch a nigga eating pussy, he got a fucking lie that's unforgivable. Nigga catching him eating pussy, motherfucker, I saw you eating that goddamn pussy. You motherfucker, you ate that pussy. Nigga looked at him and said, I wasn't eating no. Motherfucker, I saw you pull your lips from the pussy. He said, Steve, I'd fucked her so hard, the pussy was running so hot, I just put my hand down there to blow it to cool it off. And them crackers lied to. Lying motherfuckers. You catch one of them motherfuckers eating pussy, have 14 goddamn witnesses, and the motherfucker got nerve enough to look at you and say,
I was so drunk, I didn't know what I was doing.
Give me that motherfucker drunk, why need a little asshole too, goddamn it. Yes, I tell it like it is. And when you tell the truth, people sometimes look at you and say, Wild Man Steve, what kind of woman turns you on? Well, the reason why I'm going to admit it tonight is because so many women here is my kind of woman. My kind of woman is in the house tonight. Not one, not two, but a whole lot of them. And some of you might look at me and say, what is it, white woman? White ain't got nothing to do with it. Black ain't got nothing to do with it. Just a certain type of woman turned me on. I love them women with them big wide asses, goddamn it. And there's some wide ass motherfuckers here tonight. Lord knows there's some asses here tonight. And I love them to death, goddamn. Every time I see one of them white-ass women, goddamn it, I want some of it. You got one in here with an ass so big and so wide, sitting over there with her back to the wall. If the police came in here right now, said it's a raid, we got a whole ass. She'd have to make 5 trips. With that white ass she got near enough to look around and say, wonder who the fuck he's talking about. Yes, I talk about him. And I'd like to leave y'all with this particular situation. When I see a woman with a big white ass, the first goddamn thing I want to do is give her some big money. I don't mean none of that cheapskate money. I mean big fucking money. $11. Now, don't laugh. $11 don't get you a piece of pussy. Where I come from, you lease it for the whole month. She looked at my $11. She said, $11? Nigga, it would cost $11 for me to piss on you. I said, you got to be crazy. So I go across town, she wants 40. Go on the other side of town, she wants 50. I heard right back in front of the Excelsior Club. I said, hey, baby, how much you say you charge to piss on the wild man? She said, $11, nigga. I said, here's the 11, bitch. Piss in this goddamn cup. She took the 11, pissed in the cup. I took that cup of warm piss up my room, took off all my clothes, took out my ding-a-ling, dropped my ding-a-ling in that warm piss and screamed. Drink soup, motherfucker, cause meat's too high.
Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Wildman Steve. Wildman Steve. Everybody's mad.